Hello, this is Mike, and I'm going to be responding to Rob the Monk 8's video on atheism and atrocities. And he makes the claim that there is no causal link between the atheism of someone like Stalin and the atrocities that he committed. In particular, he makes the comment that this is based upon an is-ought fallacy. That just because Stalin or other people like him happen to be atheism doesn't mean that their atheism said that they ought to commit these fallacies, that there was some motivating force in their atheism that caused them to do these things. And as a theist, I'm going to agree with him. I don't believe atheism gives a motivation. And therefore, I'm not going to blame somebody's atheism for causing them to go out and do something terrible. For causing them to, you know, okay, atheism said, now I've got to go kill babies and harm people and, you know, kill 6 million Jews, as some people claim that Hitler did because he was an atheist. At least they make the claim that he's an atheist. And so I'll agree with Rob the Monk on this, but I will say that I believe that atheism does have a moral impact. As Rob the Monk 8 points out, there is no ought in atheism. So you can neither condemn atheism nor praise atheism if for someone's either condemnable actions or praiseworthy actions, because their atheism doesn't come with that sort of motivation. But I'm going to make the claim, though, that atheism does completely take the ought away, not just from the atheism motivation, but in general, if you are an atheist, the ought, the universal objective morality, is gone entirely. And so therefore, not only can you not, as an atheist, not condemn other atheists for what they do or don't do, but you have no standing to condemn religion or praise religion or on anything other than kind of personal subjective morality. In other words, it comes down to a personal feeling. So the consequence of disbelief is that there is no objective morality. There is no objective purpose. There's no ultimate consequences for things, as in after death, there's no consequences for anything. There's no ultimate meanings in anything. And so while atheism doesn't get the blame for causing things, it does get the blame for taking away the ought entirely in people's lives. Now, you'll say, you may come back and say, well, there are other reasons to believe in morality, but I think the burden of proof then goes to the disbeliever, because, or the person who is an atheist, to prove that there is such a thing as objective morality. And based upon the same types of proofs that you would demand of God or anything supernatural, because moral claims are, you know, above nature or outside of nature type of claims. Well, you can't prove them in the same way you can prove, let's say, the law of gravity or something like that. They are types of things where there is an ought, and without God, without some sort of religious claim from above, there is no ought in a universal sense. You may have a personal ought, as Rob the Monk 8 points out. I think he also makes the is-ought fallacy. Just because somebody is an atheist and also has a personal morality does not mean that that personal morality has any function in society outside of himself. He has it internally, but that's not really morality. That's a personal code of behavior. Morality is something that would be imposed on society, that you would look to other people to also follow those same standards. And I believe that atheism undercuts that. Therefore, while atheism does not cause atrocity, it also has no force either personally or societally to stop atrocities. The actual motivations for atrocities may come from any number of things, including sexual perversion, greed, just hunger for power, and also, yes, religious motivations. Oftentimes people do things out of religious motivations, even things that other people would call bad. Whatever the cause, though, atheism has no power to speak to such atrocities. In fact, the term atrocity itself is a value-laden term that has no objective meaning at all in a universe without objective values. Thus, when Stalin rejects a belief in God, this does not automatically turn him into a monster, but it does free him from any objective moral constraints that his previous beliefs may have put on him. Whatever constraints he puts on himself are purely self-imposed, or perhaps imposed by society. But of course, by the end of his life, he had enough power that the societal restraints were limited only by the military might of the Western world. And so within the Eastern Bloc countries, where he had control, he could pretty much do anything that was physically possible as a ruler. He had such power that whatever he wanted to do, he could do with really no consequence to himself. And if there's no personal morality, no oughtness inside of himself that he thought he shouldn't do it, why not kill people? It doesn't matter. Likewise, when some atheists, and as I assume Rob the Monk 8 would be one of these, choose to restrain their behavior based on certain personal or societal ideas or limits, that's great. But it's a purely an arbitrary, you know, arbitrary rule and dependent upon either the individual or the society in which they live. Therefore, they basically become free moral agents, with the only constraint being their own mind and whatever limits society can impose. G.K. Chesterton once made this statement. He said that when people stop believing in God, it's not that they believe in nothing, but rather that they will believe anything. Therefore, people who stop believing in God are free to do whatever they like. What we might call atrocities occur when someone believes they have the right to do what other people would call evil. Sometimes this can come from a religious belief, and that belief, you know, you believe that you're superior and have the right to harm someone else, do something that the majority of people would call evil. But it also could come from a non-religious belief that there are simply no absolutes to which a person needs to conform. Therefore, whatever other types of motivations would be free to be followed because there'd be no constraints on those things. You see, religious belief actually is a constraining force to all kinds of other forces and motivations that you might have. See, when atheists criticize religions about causing atrocities, I think they sound silly because they really have nothing of substance to offer to replace whatever bad morality they are criticizing. See, Rob is right. Atheism does not cause atrocities. It does not necessarily encourage any behavior, good or bad. But it, as he says, it doesn't discourage any behavior either, good or bad. If you're an atheist then, just remember that atrocities don't objectively exist. That term is a personal value judgment that some people, maybe you, make about the actions of some other free moral agent to do what they've done. And you may not like that personally, but that's simply an act that some other free moral agent made, and you have no more standing to criticize them than they would to criticize you. You don't have any specific atheistic reason to cause atrocity, but you are free to do whatever you want to do as long as you can get away with it. And that's the moral code that an atheist would live under. Therefore, atheism does not cause or motivate atrocities in and of itself. It simply removes all barriers for any other motivation that someone might have to cause atrocities. Have a good day.